for n equals 0 to 2. Those were the days next n.
ElectroBots is a flick screen graphic adventure in which you take control of three different bots in three different graphic adventures. There are many reasons why this is a brilliant idea, but before I get into those, let's just stick with the initial adventure. Here you can trundle left and right and explore the colourful landscape of Terra Nova, collecting all the objects you find. There are the usual keys which unlock doors and patrolling nasties to avoid. If you were limited to this, then obviously ElectroBots wouldn't be particularly mold-breaking. However, with a quick tap of key 2, you'll be given control of a different bot who is somewhere in the ocean. In this adventure, you must swim left and right, and the bot handles completely differently. Then there's bot 3, who's somewhere up in space, and who glides around in all directions as if he's wearing a jetpack. This makes for a game that has a great deal of playability and lastability. The puzzles are hard too, so it should take you quite some time to work out how to beat all three bits. Now here's something a bit different. A monochrome platform game that plays at supersonic speed and involves collecting zeros and ones. ELEMENTUM is a seriously fast game. There's no real story other than that you are, quote, a brave electron, unquote, by which I think they mean ball. You have to collect up the status flags, and it's written entirely in machine code. It needs a lot of concentration, and in return you get infinite lives and a sort of instant reincarnation when you inevitably collide with a patrolling nasty or fall down a hole. This is a fairly new game from the new guys Retro Power, and because there are so few new Electron games these days, I really wish that it was better than it is. However, the speed and the pixel-perfect positioning required simply make it too hard to be a lot of fun. To give it its due, it's different, and it is fairly addictive for a while. But having given up on level 6, it's not a game that I think I'll be returning to anytime soon. Up next is the iconic LODE RUNNER, a classic ladders and levels game first popularised on the Apple II. It's been vexing arcade gamers ever since, and the Electron version is exactly what you'd expect. A straight-up port of the original, in which you must collect up all of the red squares whilst evading the surprisingly intelligent three runners. If you manage it, a hitherto invisible ladder appears, allowing you to clamber to the safety of the next screen. The game takes real skill, which is why its popularity endures even to this day. You can't destroy the runners, you can only get them off your back temporarily by outrunning them or by digging a hole into which they might fall, but they quickly fill it in and come right back after you. This might not be much to look at, but even all these years later, I can barely describe the sense of achievement you get when you clear a new screen. Try it, you will love it. Manic Miner was the precursor to Jet Set Willy, and hands up all of you who are thinking, hang on, I know full well Manic Miner didn't come out on the Electron. Well, you're all right. In point of fact, the Electron never got a conversion of this much-loved Spectrum game. But, as of 2021, this particular omission has been remedied by Nullex Code, and Electron owners can now enjoy the delights of the mines where Willy made his fortune. Finally. And it's really good. All of the tricky levels with their tight time limits and different bad guy sprites have made it across, and somehow it's all been done in just 16k of memory, meaning it appears almost identically to the original. Even the ELK conversion of Jet Set Willy was in monochrome, so this is a real bonus. Oh, and in case you're wondering, in Manic Miner, if you get killed, you start the screen again from the same initial position. So there's none of that infinite reincarnating death loop nonsense that pervaded the sequel. As there's no physical release of this game, yet, you'll find it on either everygamegoing.com or Stairway to Hell's forums, and it's definitely worth a download. The Darkness of Raven Wood is an illustrated text adventure, in which the year is 1862. You play a young man who's come to Ravenwood Manor after receiving a few worrying letters from his friend Reynard. The village has been beset by a pack of howling wolves, the priest has mysteriously disappeared, and it all seems to be connected with the arrival of a mysterious stranger. Graphically, this adventure is superb. It's disc only, and the pictures have been designed freehand and then compressed, so they load fast and they look gorgeous. There are a few chaining puzzles to solve and a few characters to meet, which all seem in keeping with the gothic horror theme. Part 1 of the adventure, Voices in Two Parts, is almost entirely logical. You can find this adventure for free online, and a physical disc is currently for sale from Retro Software and priced at $12.99. Fans of Twin Kingdom Valley and the Lost Crystal will definitely want to check it out.